What is event sourcing? What's the difference with CQRS? Are they worthy SL? Let's discover it in the next few minutes. Event sourcing is an architectural pattern where all state changes are represented as events and recorded in an append-only log. The easiest way to understand this is to compare it to a traditional application. In a typical CRUD application, we would store products as records or documents in a database. When the seller creates the product, a corresponding record is saved on the database. If the seller decides to update the price or any other property of this product, we simply modify the value in the existing record. Our application is persisting only the current state of the product. This approach is perfectly fine for most scenarios. However, it has one major drawback: data loss. In fact, what would happen if we were requested to provide a history of all changes applied to this product? In event sourcing, all actions performed by the seller or any other user would result in state changes that are recorded as events in the append-only log. When the seller creates a product created event is generated. Any update to the product is stored as an event as well. The events are rich in context. They obviously carry the product details, but they can also embed important information like the author, time, and reason for the change. Now we have solved the problem of data loss, but we are not ready yet. In fact, while we can list all the changes that happened in the system, we are now unable to define the current state of the product. And this is where the sourcing portion of the pattern comes into play. In order to list product and their details, we still need a view of our domain, because it would be difficult and inefficient to figure out the last state of the product by looking at the event log alone. In simpler words, we still need to reconstruct our entity or aggregate. The only difference with the traditional approach is that, rather than populating the model by applying changes every time we serve an API request, we source it from the event log. Now we have both history and current state. The process of reconstructing our domain object is called hydration. In this diagram, we are performing the hydration continuously by consuming events and materializing the view in a database. However, it's also very common to hydrate the model during startup of the app or on need by accessing directly the event log. Now, there's no denying that this approach is really cool. I recall it seeing it for the first time at a conference and spending the following evening and night writing my first event source application. However, we need to be very careful. Event sourcing comes with incredible benefits, but also massive headaches that you need to be aware of before deciding whether to use it or not. But before we get to discuss them, let's figure out how CQRS and event sourcing are related. In CQRS, command and query responsibilities are segregated. In simpler words, operations that are meant to change the state of our app are modeled as commands, while those that just retrieve the data are modeled as queries. The segregation means that commands and queries must be processed by independent portion of our application or system. In the context of a monolith, CQRS can be achieved defining separate services or modules. In a microservices architecture, we can go a step further and have completely independent microservices. Greg Young introduced this pattern back in 2010 and later described it as a stepping stone towards event sourcing. The reason is obvious. In event sourcing, the service that populates the event log is dealing with commands, while the service that is materializing the domain model is meant to serve queries. Now it's time to answer the question, is event sourcing as good as it looks? As usual, online you'll find lists telling you that event sourcing can also solve your back pain. But let's focus only on the most important ones. Auditing is number one. It's undeniable that event sourcing preserves the entire history of our data and protects it from tampering. Events are immutable. We can append events to the log, but never modify them. If for any reason we want to revert the change caused by an event, we need to perform a compensating action, which would result in an additional event in the log. Another super cool advantage is the ability to time travel and replay events. Since the domain model is hydrated by processing the events, we can easily go back in time just by pointing to an earlier position in the event log. This can be very useful to debug, perform what-if analysis, and what I find really awesome is refactoring our domain model. Imagine that for some reason we want to change the structure of our tables or documents in the database. All we need to do is deploy a new version of our application, replay all events, and we're done. No data migration is necessary. No headaches. The same approach can be used for disaster recovery. As long as we keep our event log well replicated or backed up, we will always be able to reconstruct the current state. Finally, the last key advantage is that event sourcing fosters low coupling in our system. In fact, event sourcing works really well with an event-driven architecture, where microservices communicate through messages rather than synchronous API or RPC calls. I'll link some videos in the description that dig deeper into this particular topic. And now, time for the bad news. Is event sourcing a pattern you should use in your next project? Before I answer, let me show you some drawbacks of this approach. The list of challenges is very long, and it would require more than one video to cover each point. Let's make a summary. We cannot deny that event sourcing increases the complexity of our applications. Nothing comes for free. In a typical application, we just need to populate our database, while in an event source system, we have the burden of creating and maintaining the event log and hydrating the model from events. That doesn't come out of thin air. We need to design and code such a solution. We also need to select an event log able to support the load generated by our application. It needs to be able to store a large number of events and potentially serve many requests per second. There's also the problem that replaying all events to hydrate our model becomes inefficient over time. Queries and application start type can take very long. In that case, it might be necessary to persist the model or introduce snapshots events that capture the state of an entity at a certain point in time. It's a bit like saving the progress on a video game. Rather than starting from scratch, we resume event processing from the last snapshot. Modifying events is forbidden, so changing the format of events is painful. We either lift the restriction, replay all events to create new ones, or use event upcasters that transform the old events format to the new format on the fly. We also need to mention eventual consistency. This can be seen as a benefit and drawback at the same time. It's a benefit because it helps increase resilience and availability of our system. However, it may complicate life when we attempt a read after write. In a typical application, we would perform the update in a single transaction, keeping the system always in a consistent state. When implementing event sourcing in conjunction with an event-driven architecture, there might be some delay until the action is fully replicated in the system. That means that we can get stale information if we query right after an update. Sometimes the actions could be conflicting, but the conflict is detected only when the events are processed, which is after they are stored in the event log. This is another scenario where we need to solve the conflict, which we would do it with compensating actions or just by disregarding some particular event. There's much more, but I want to stop here. If you want to know more, just leave me a comment. Now, time for the conclusion. Should we use event sourcing? My answer is no.
What did you say? What did you say?
Unless you have a real need for it. In my opinion, there is value if you have strict auditing requirements or if the historical data stored in the event log gives important insights to your business. If that's not the case, why adding the complexity to your architecture? I wouldn't bother with it unless you want to have fun on a side project just for the sake of learning the pattern. However, if you really want to try it, I'd suggest having a look at the Exyn framework. It's incredibly well structured and documented, and you can easily get started in a few minutes. Even if you decide to write your own solution, Exyn can be a good way to learn how certain challenges of event sourcing can be solved. So make sure to take inspiration. If you disagree with my conclusion, don't be lazy and write me a comment with your opinion. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share the video so that everyone can learn something new.